I have something I want to tell you.
Would you classify yourself as a bridezilla?
No, I don't think so.
I have something I want to tell you. I have something I want to tell you. I'm not like other guys.
Of course not. That's why I love you.
No, I mean I'm different. I'm not like other guys.
Like day off of work today, and all I did was go to like Jack in the Box and Taco Bell and pick Julius up from the airport, so I don't think that classifies as a bridezilla.
I have something I want to tell you. I have something I want to tell you.
I don't know. I mean, I don't think our wedding is very complicated. I actually thought ours was pretty easy, but we're both very like simple people, so. We're not doing like flowers or colors or anything.
I put amen and it changed it to mummet.
There's got to be a way for me to turn off autocorrect though.
Yeah, you're an English teacher. You don't need it.
No, I don't need autocorrect at all. I don't like autocorrect.
Yeah, I told someone that I was going down here for my former high school teacher's wedding. I said,
that
wow.
That sounds weird when you say that.
And they said, wow, she's getting married late in life. And I'm like, no, she's not old at all. She started her career very young.
Oh my God.
Because when people hear teacher, they think old automatically. And nice. I don't know why.
Classy. Well, I am kind of older to get married, let's be honest.
I think old
people
married.
Get married like in their 20s or.
Shit, people wish they got married in their 20s. Okay, so you didn't sleep well?
Well, that fire alarm, the whole nightmare woke me up, and I couldn't, like, go back to sleep.
What is this?
He left me, I know.
Oh. So the groom-to-be left you a note before he left. So you're getting married today.
Uh-huh. I'm wearing my tea right now.
I see that. What type of toothpaste? How are you feeling in terms of nerves?
No, I'm okay. I'm just worried about food. It's always about the food. Because my blood sugar, I have blood sugar problems, so anytime I eat, it affects me either well or like bad. So I'm concerned about the food.
Mm.
Definitely.
The food will come.
Food will it will definitely come.
It's just the afterwards.
What would happen? Oh, I'm not allowed to complain though. Hyland made me promise that no complaining today, and I think that was complaining, right?
Well, that's a good thing. No complaining.
So you have to remind me.
Good. I will. Oh, I will.
I've been in many car accidents, so I get a little.
Oh.
You know.
I've never been in any.
Oh, that's good. That's awesome. But when poor Hyland, when he drives me, he's always like, Kelly, it's fine. And I was like, whoa. And like, I am like grabbing the oh shit bar all the time. And he's like, what's wrong? I'm like, close there. I was like, I'm always like breathing.
I used to be a limo driver.
Oh, that's right.
Nice. I know how to drive. People pay a lot of money for me to drive.
He didn't
get
my text. He's right. My texts aren't delivering.
So Kelly, what are we doing? Where are we? What's happening right now?
Oh, you're videotaping. That's why you're asking me this question. I was about to be like, you already know what we're doing. We're going to Blow Boss to get my hair and makeup done in Burbank.
It's called Blow Boss.
Well, the guy, Sam, owns it, so that's why, you know, I think he's the Blow Boss.
Oh, blow, as it B-O-S-S?
Yes.
Oh.
Oh my gosh, I didn't bring a big thing of hairspray. I have a little one.
It's a hair salon.
I'm at our destination. Oh, right there. Sorry, right there. Turn around, though. See if we can park right in front.
It says 30-minute parking.
Oh,
never
no.
Never mind, you gotta park back then. You can take the dress in.
Oh, you wanna do that?
Well, we might have to, because I always park, see over there by that building. I park on that one. It's 2 hours. Oh, but we're gonna be here more than 2 hours. Awesome. Gotta get out of here. I'm gonna be centering myself every time I see that camera.
Well, how does it feel being all dolled up for the big day?
It's fine, Julius.
Tell the truth.
She said we're a funny species.
Yes.
Did you use a pink ball to put on makeup?
Makeup in general, it's like... You know, you're born and you have this skin and you're like, let me put paint on it. It's just, it's pretty silly.
But you look gorgeous. I mean, you were gorgeous without it. This just enhanced your features and now you're camera ready.
Yeah, there's going to be plenty of that.
Are we all done?
Yeah, with the makeup portion, yeah.
Let's be here.
You're welcome.
Yeah, Mark.
One more. gives it, who gives this bride in marriage?
Her mother and myself.
So the bride in the groom would come up on the altar. All right, you may turn and walk into your beautiful picture.
I saw Terry.
I'm not kidding.
You caught it.
Funeral.
So what are you going to do with that now?
Okay, let's get the fountain in though.
Yeah.
I'm tripping.
Well, you got jogging shoes on.
Thank you for coming.
Yeah.
You guys are going to go to the Brass for a big family one.
Perfect.
Big family.
Okay, we're following the beat.
Kelly Hyland, bring us all together.
She didn't know I was going to tell this story. But, so a little over 3 years ago, I met this girl, and we had a connection. And I really liked her, and I asked her out, and she said, no.
Dating at that.
She wasn't dating at the time. I said, hey, no problem. So we exchanged numbers and I stayed in touch for a few months. And then one day the stars must have been completely aligned because she agreed to have lunch with me. And we went out to lunch and that turned into about an 8 hour long date of talking and getting to know each other, and it ended with a kiss. you should have seen her face. She didn't see it coming at all.
On the first date?
It was a very innocent kiss. Anyways, we were soon to be a couple, and so today I married the girl who stole my heart.
And I know some people traveled some very long distances from Hyland's family came from Missouri. And I know some of you came from Arizona. Some of you drove up from San Diego. Some of you flew in from San Francisco. So I just want to say I really do appreciate you all for coming. And I know I maybe don't see some of you, you know, every single, you know, moment I have. And I really appreciate those of you who are my true friends and my true family. And I really do appreciate that you came to support us. So thank you.
And now if I could have Kelly's mom, Carol, for the blessing of the meal.
Hi, we are very happy to have so many family and friends here today. We thank, especially as Kelly said, the people that have come from long distances. But we also want to remember the relatives that aren't here, maybe because they couldn't make it, but also ones that have gone on and are here in spirit with both of them. So all family members, you know, your gatherings. So we just want to bless this food we're about to eat and to all the people who have prepared this meal for us. And let us think about all those who do not have enough food at this time. And I just want to close with a little Irish blessing. A wish that every day will be happy from the start, and may you always have good luck and a song within your heart. Amen.
I'm going to give a little toast to my bro and my new sis-in-law. First of all, I want to say how beautiful Kelly looks. Right, everybody? So bad yourself, bro. So I have a lot of good memories of Hyland. Some when we were younger, like give me a lot of noogies on the head, chasing me downstairs, teasing me. But no, he was pretty good though. He's a good brother, and I'm happy for him. Happy for Kelly. I didn't get it. This is only my second time I've met Kelly, because she came up to Missouri in July, and this is the second time since I've been here that I've met her, so. But they are just a really good couple. They just are meant for each other, I think. So, I just wanted to say congratulations and thanks for welcoming everybody here, and we welcome you into our family, Kelly. So I'm not going to keep it long, but so you can all go ahead and get on with your food and the drinks. So here's the toast to Kelly and Hyland.
Cheers.
That was one of the most beautiful ceremonies I have ever witnessed. I've waited long for this day, for the union of Hyland and Kelly. From the first moment I saw them together, I knew that they were destined. They were true soulmates. I am so happy for both of them. I'm overwhelmed. And I welcome Kelly to our family. She is a beautiful addition to our family. She looked like Cinderella at the ball today. Yeah. And Hyland looked so handsome. I wish them happiness 100%. They know what I mean by that. Anyway. Here's to Hyland and Kelly. Church.
I want to apologize because my voice is a little hoarse right now. But this is a bit last minute. I didn't prepare anything too elaborate. I just wanted to speak because I have known the two of you since the beginning, as you know. And I've known Kelly since about, 05? And a decade later, here we are. And I just think it's just wonderful that the two of you together now and it's been solidified and the sanctity of marriage. It's really wonderful. But you said something, Hyland, the other day, or yesterday, that I've been rooting for the two of you since the beginning. And I felt kind of bad when you said that because that wasn't always the case. This is a hilarious story, I promise you. But Kelly called me to tell me that she had gone out on her first date, with Hyland. And I didn't know anything about him, didn't even know his name. And I don't know what it was, she was driving through an area that had a terrible reception. So I could not understand really what she was saying. So as I was on the phone, I said, tell me how the date went. And she's talking, and I say, And then, when they say, what? I said, I'm going to be completely honest, Kelly. This guy doesn't sound too good. I mean, to be honest, I'm a little concerned for your safety. And I said, because, on a first date in this day and age, you're supposed to go to dinner, you're supposed to go to a movie. But you're telling me that this man took you to his church on Hyland? I said, where on Hyland is this church? What denomination is this church? Is it a church or is it a cult? Was everyone fully dressed when you walked in? Just didn't make any sense to me, but she finally got home and explained the whole thing. And so, of course, as time has progressed and I've met Hyland, he's turned out to be a really great guy. And, no crazy cult churches. So, that's a good thing. But I just want to say that it's so beautiful just witnessing the two of you and the ceremony today. It was so lovely. And I just think that, I always tell people there's certain things in life that we can plan. We can go and plan to go to school. We can plan a vacation. We can plan to even open a business. Those are things that we, with our own stubborn effort, can achieve. But you can't really plan to get married. No matter what you do, no matter how you set yourself forth in order to find someone, a lot of times, there's no guarantee. And so when you find someone that you love and you connect with, it's just so, I can't even express to you how beautiful it is when it ends the way that it's ended today. And I just really am honored that I was a part of it. And I thank you all both for having me. Thank you.
Why we're celebrating this special young lady today and her new husband. Kelly is just, as everyone knows, and I think her friendships have attested to that, how she has maintained friendships from elementary school, high school, and these people that came today. She is just such a great person, and the fact that she's not afraid to speak her mind, so she always has everybody's best intentions at heart, and that's why I also love her so much, because she always cares about all of us, especially like our siblings, and never afraid to, be honest and always looking out for us. So I very cherish that. My sister's always been very driven and she got her master's. She's an awesome teacher. And all I can say is the students that have my sister are the darnest, luckiest kids ever out there because she is just awesome. Oh, I mean, they're right. So fortunate. She's overcome so many challenges in some of the environments she teaches and I just applaud her for that. So they're so fortunate. Kelly is just such a great person to talk to. She's so funny. Anybody who sits next to Kelly, she can tell you stories and you'll be rolling on the floor all day, and I love that. And she's so much fun to sing with. She knows all the lyrics, and she can dance up the storm. So I'm looking forward to that tonight, too. So I'm so grateful that she found someone, a companion, that she can share her life with now, because it isn't, I know how important and what a big step that is to take, and to find somebody that's special to do that with is just, it's a great joy. So we're all so happy for Kelly, and she deserves all this special day, the two of you together. And I'm looking forward to meeting more of Hyland's family, too. So. And welcome to the quirky Fletcher family. If people don't know it, we are very quirky. So, yeah. And so welcome to the church family, too. So take care, and we love you. Thank you very much.
This is a song that was written years ago for another woman, her mother. You're so fine, oh wonder of love and your mind. I draw forth my strength from the depth of your love. As the earth gives its life to the flowers and the doves, you're my shadow, yes, you're my dream, the bell of my heart, make my spirit ring. Light of my life, you help to make me shine. Very best of all, you're mine. Thank God for your spirit. Thank God for your heart. Thank God for the one. Thank God for your will, thank God for your mind, thank God for the love he let me find. Thank God for the pain, thank God for the hurt, thank God for the gentle way. Show me your love. Thank God for the one we are, fashioned up above. And praise be him, I see in you, my angel of
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Red!